let's do this thing. I've been working on my blinking. See, I do know how to blink. Alright.
Originally playing the tuba, Paul Chambers made the switch to the double bass in 1949, and by 1955, he was playing with the Miles Davis Quintet, alongside John Coltrane, Red Garland, and Philly Joe Jones. He would continue to work with the quintet through various lineups until 1963. During his short career as a bassist, Chambers played with just about everyone on the scene. Miles Davis, John Coltrane, Cannonball Adderley, Nat Adderley, Chet Baker, Kenny Burrell, Kenny Clarke, Kenny Dorham, Kenny Drew, Dexter Gordon, Hank Mobley, I could go on. There's a good reason why Paul Chambers was held in such high regard as a jazz bassist in the 1950s and 60s. Well, there are many reasons. Paul Chambers not only had a roaring bass tone, rock-solid time feel, incredible stamina, and great intonation, but his walking lines were beautiful. Let's take a look at the way Paul Chambers approached the classic chord progression known as the rhythm changes. Today's transcription comes from the Miles Davis album, Relaxin' with the Miles Davis Quintet, to the Sonny Rollins tune, Oleo. Fun fact, Relaxin', along with three additional albums, Steamin', Workin', and Cookin' with the Miles Davis Quintet, was recorded over two sessions in 1956, but would not be released for another 2 years. We'll be focusing on select line fragments from the first two choruses. A link to the full walking transcription can be found in the description below. Let's have a listen. It's impressive to me that Chambers is not only able to walk and maintain good time for 11 choruses at 260 BPM, but also create smooth and melodic bass lines. Let's start with a few generalities about his walking approach. He doesn't always play the root on a new chord change. He uses thirds, sevenths, and other chord substitutions to great effect. This is important for developing lines that sound more like melodies and provides a sort of root relief, if you will. Chambers' lines on this track are very compact, grounded in left-hand positions like half position for extended durations. This is obviously advantageous when playing at faster tempos, as you minimize hand and arm movement as much as possible. The second A section of the melody, where the bass comes in, is a great example of walking in half position. If you're unfamiliar with this term, it's essentially the lowest fingering position on the double bass, from the open strings to where the third fret would be on a bass guitar. The B section offers more freedom with the sparseness of the chord changes. Chambers chooses to outline the chord progression with mostly scales. The final A section of the melody is probably my favourite of the whole transcription. The chromatic line in the last two bars is just awesome. Check out how he uses the open strings to smoothly transition into the higher positions. There's so much more to talk about in this transcription, but to wrap it up, I want to jump ahead to the final A section in the second chorus. What makes Chambers' lines so great is they sound like melodies, and they sound like melodies because they follow melody writing techniques. For example, it's very common to write a melody in a scalar motion followed by a leap in the opposite direction, or to play a melodic idea as a sequence. This final A section is a great example of these ideas. It's also played entirely in half position. I would actually recommend memorizing this particular A section because it's just so good.
That's all for now. Check the links in the description for the full transcription and other good stuff. If you like this video, please consider supporting the channel by making a donation. The more you pay, the more you learn, and no donation is too large. Thank you very much. Until the next one, take care.